When we think of the Bees, we think of these three. Marchand, Bergeron, Pasternak. That top line, ridiculous. Their numbers, staggering. It's a known commodity. What you're getting from that unit, game in, game out. Got us to thinking, oh, gentlemen, our experts, is this the top line in the National Hockey League? The answer.
I'm going to say no.
Ooh.
Yes, I know. I'm an
former
expert.
Bruin, by the
That's
way.
Okay. I'm going with another team that I was former team of. And I'm going with Nathan MacKinnon.
Won a cup with the Avs, so. Yes.
So right now, I'm saying that even though MacKinnon got shut out last game 1-0 on a controversial offside call, that would have
first game this year he has been
way.
On the score sheet.
Yeah, either way. Yes. But for me, the Boston Bruins line is going to be in the top five. That'll be talked about constantly. We talked about it last year as the best line in the game. Mm. And over the course of a season, I think you'd probably end up putting these two lines 1-2 going right now. Mm-hmm. I like the Sebastian Aho line down in Carolina as well. They're playing pretty well. But right now, the Philadelphia Flyers have to concern themselves with the Marchand line. But for me, Nathan MacKinnon with Mikko Rantanen and Gabe Landeskog, they're big, they're strong, they're getting the job done on a nightly basis. We keep saying, who's the second line in Colorado? You don't have to worry about a second line in Colorado right now. You've got goaltending. And you've got this line. These guys are big. They're strong. They move the puck extremely well. They can all score goals. And that's right now, to me, they're the number one line. No question. Maybe the Bergeron line is just that they've just done it so long. They're just so good. And Pasternak just keeps sliding the puck between his legs.
Incredible.
But right now, I've got them, I think I had them number three, my top third line. I had the Aho line up there, number two.
Great start for them.